Hi friends. Welcome to my channel. Today, we can see about very important topic. In the mechanical field, teeth equipment is very important. Without teeth equipment, no mechanic M. We can see in the video. What's teeth equipment? If you are a new person to my channel, subscribe my channel and press bell icon. We can see about teeth equipment. The other name of teeth equipment is called gear. Let's today we see about gear history and types of gears, which have been preserved at the Luoyang Museum of Henan Province, China. The earliest preserved gears in Europe were found in the Antikythera mechanism. An example of a very early and intricate gear device, designed to calculate astronomical positions. Its time of construction is now estimated between 150 and 100 BC. Gears appear in works connected to Hero of Alexandria in Roman Egypt circa AD 50, but can be traced back to the mechanics of the Alexandrian school in 3rd century BC. Ptolemaic Egypt, and were greatly developed by the Greek polymath Archimedes 287 to 212 BC. The segmental gear, which receives communicates reciprocating motion to a cogwheel, consisting of a sector of a circular gear or ring having cogs on the periphery, was invented by Arab engineer Al-Jazari in 1206. The worm gear was invented in the Indian subcontinent for use in roller cotton gins sometime during the 13th-14th centuries. What is a gear? Gear is a simple machine with teeth that increases the force needed to push or pull something. They serve to keep the turning or rotation of two axes together. Gears can increase or decrease the speed of rotation and can easily be used to reverse the direction of rotation. Another reason gears are essential is that they transmit rotational motion to a different axis. Gears can be classified by shape as involute, cycloidal and trochoidal gears. Also, they can be classified by shaft positions as parallel shaft gears, intersecting shaft gears, and non-parallel and non-intersecting shaft gears. There are many types of gears such as spur gears, helical gears, bevel gears, worm gears, gear rack, etc. These can be broadly classified by looking at the positions of axes, such as parallel shafts, intersecting shafts and non-intersecting shafts. It is necessary to accurately understand the differences among gear types to accomplish necessary force transmission in mechanical designs. Now we can see types of gears and its uses. Spur gear. Spur gears belong to the parallel shaft gear group and are cylindrical gears with a tooth line, which is straight and parallel to the shaft. Spur gears are the most widely used gears that can achieve high accuracy with relatively easy production processes. They have the characteristic of having no load and the axial direction thrust load. The larger of the meshing pair is called the gear and smaller is called the pinion. Helical gear. Helical gears are used with parallel shafts, similar to spur gears, and are cylindrical gears with winding tooth lines. They have better teeth and meshing than spur gears and have superior quietness and can transmit higher loads, making them suitable for high-speed applications. When using helical gears, they create thrust force in the axial direction, necessitating the use of thrust bearings. Helical gears come with right hand and left hand twist, requiring opposite hand gears for meshing pair. Gear rack. A gear rack is a cylindrical gear, with the radius of the pitch cylinder being infinite. Same sized and shaped teeth cut at equal distances along a flat surface or a straight rod is called a gear rack. By meshing with a cylindrical gear pinion, it converts rotational motion into linear motion. Gear racks can be broadly divided into straight tooth racks and helical tooth racks, but both have straight tooth lines. By machining the ends of gear racks, it is possible to connect gear racks end to end. Bevel gear. Bevel gears have a cone-shaped appearance and are used to transmit force between two shafts which intersect at one point intersecting shafts. A beveled gear has a cone as its pitch surface, and its teeth are cut along the cone. Kinds of beveled gears include straight beveled gears, helical beveled gears, spiral beveled gears, miter gears, angular beveled gears, crown gears, zero beveled gears and hypoid gears. Spiral beveled gear. Spiral beveled gears are beveled gears with curved tooth lines. Due to higher tooth contact ratio, they are superior to straight beveled gears in efficiency, strength, vibration and noise. On the other hand, they are more difficult to produce. Also, because the teeth are curved, they cause thrust forces in the axial direction. Within the spiral beveled gears, the one with the zero twisting angle is called zero bevel gear. Screw gear. Screw gears are a pair of same hand helical gears with the twist angle of 45 degree on non-parallel, non-intersecting shafts. Because the tooth contact is a point, their load carrying capacity is low and they are not suitable for large power transmission. Since power is transmitted by the sliding of the tooth surfaces, it is necessary to pay attention to lubrication when using screw gears. There are no restrictions as far as the combinations of number of teeth. Miter gear. Miter gears are beveled gears with a speed ratio of 1. They are used to change the direction of power transmission without changing speed. There are straight miter and spiral miter gears. When using the spiral miter gears, it becomes necessary to consider using thrust bearings, since they produce thrust force in the axial direction. Besides the usual miter gears with 90 degree shaft angles, miter gears with any other shaft angles are called angular miter gears. Worm gear. A screw-shaped cut on a shaft is the worm. The mating gear is the worm wheel, and together on non-intersecting shafts is called the worm gear. Worms and worm wheels are not limited to cylindrical shapes. There is the hourglass type, which can increase the contact ratio, but production becomes more difficult due to the sliding contact of the gear surfaces. It is necessary to reduce friction. For this reason, generally a hard material is used for the worm, and a soft material is used for worm wheel. Even though the efficiency is low due to the sliding contact, the rotation is smooth and quiet. When the leaf angle of the worm is small, it creates a self-locking feature. Internal gear. Internal gears have teeth cut on the inside of cylinders or cones and are paired with external gears. The main use of internal gears are for planetary gear drives and gear type shaft couplings. There are limitations in the number of teeth differences between internal and external gears due to involute interference, trochoid interference and trimming problems. The rotational directions of the internal and external gears in mesh are the same while they are opposite when two external gears are in mesh. Thank you for watching my channel. If you like my video, subscribe my channel. We can see different topic quickly in next video.